the movie of the week. Presenting the world premiere of an original motion picture produced especially for ABC. Tonight on the movie of the week.
Jimmy, they're really dangerous.
Yeah, they use these streets like a drag strip.
You all right, honey?
Yeah.
You know, we ought to do something before some kid gets hurt.
Those folks who feel the same way we do about trying to, well, hold down this drag strip racing that goes on in the streets around here, have already signed up.
What we need are stop signs and speed bumps, and your signature would certainly be greatly appreciated.
We checked, first of all, the Homeowners Association and then the Sheriff's Department, and they all suggested we petition directly for more money for speed bumps and for stop signs and so forth to try to calm it down a little.
First time anyone did more than complain about these kids. I'll sign.
They're gonna ruin their shot. Better pull over, man. Pigs on our tail.
faster, sir. I'm hurt. I'm bleeding.
That's not nearly how badly you'll be hurting after I get through with you.
Honest, sir, I didn't see the stop sign. I'm not used to it being there.
The stop sign? That's just a bit of it. This time I'm hanging you up on reckless driving, speeding, going through that stop sign and driving on the wrong side of the street, sonny boy. After what you guys have been doing around here, I wouldn't be a bit surprised if this is going to cost you $750.
Oh, come on, man.
Let me see your license, Chandler.
Man, honestly, my lip really hurts, man.
Let me see your driver's license.
Down in my own yard.
Oh, honey, look at your hand.
It's not as bad as it looks. Wait a minute. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Wait a minute. Let me sit down.
Wait a minute. Here, maybe this will help.
Yeah. Yeah, that feels good. Hey, Oliver. You had it closer than yourself, didn't you, old timer?
Did you see who it was?
Oh, it was a little brown car. I never saw it before. But the other one was Vance Chandler.
Oliver, Chandler? Look at our neighbors. Why would they do a thing like that, try to kill you?
Well...
Oliver, kid.
I guess we ruined their drag strip with our petition.
What?
No, that was the difficult part. I couldn't get the license number because I was being run over by a car at the time. It was brown. Yes, it was a brown car, a small brown car. It was a foreign car of a recent model. It was a convertible. But I told all of this to the sheriff's department. They suggested I contact the highway patrol. That's you, isn't it? I see. Yes, of course. I understand. Of course. Yes. Thank you. Thank you very much.
What did they say?
They can't make a move without more information.
Well, what more information do they need? All they have to do is look at your hand.
I don't really know, but it's, obvious that I'm going to have to find it out for myself.
Where are you going?
Across the street. I will talk to Vance Chandler.
Could I have a kiss first?
Certainly. What was that for?
To sweeten you up a bit. To improve your temper.
Temper? What temper? I'm just going across the street for a neighborly visit. But I'll be back in a few minutes. Hold that mood.
Dr. Kyler.
Healer of beasts.
Mrs. Chandler.
Come in. Just having a little taste. Won't you join me?
No, I don't think I will at the moment, thank you. I wanted to talk to Vance if I could.
Vance? Vance is out somewhere.
Well, his car is in the driveway, Mrs. Chandler.
Oh, is it? Maybe I didn't hear him come in. Vance? Are you in there? Just because his car is outside, that doesn't necessarily mean he's here. I mean, these boys all drive one another's cars all the time, you know. Vance?
What?
You're right. Here's the Phantom of Dragstrip Hollow.
Vance, I'd like to know who's driving the car that hit me this morning.
Gosh, Dr. Kyler, what car?
You know what car. You were right behind it.
What the devil are you doing, throwing fruit into my fireplace?
If I go out the door, I'm going to call the sheriff's office. Now, do you want that? Or do you want to answer my question? I understand there's a $750 fine hanging over you now.
He's a friend of mine. He doesn't live around here.
Who is he? Where does he live?
His name is Carl Dibble, and he lives in Wheaton.
Where in Wheaton?
I don't know the name of the street. I could get there. It's near the armory. But I don't know the name of the street.
I'll find it. Goodbye, Mrs. Chandler.
Oh, stop by anytime.
Honey, remember you have to have him clipped all over and all the way to the skin and keep him away from any dried grass, any old grass. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Fox tails. It'll be 50% of my business between now and September. I can't get anybody to cut their grass.
Howdy there, Doctor. I'm Officer Geary.
Yes, sir. I understand you have some news for me.
I do.
We found your brown Triumph TR6.
That's what it was.
Yes. It was registered to Raymond Dibble. He lives at 21348 Benoit Street in Wheaton. He also has a son, Carl, who's 17, who's authorized to drive the car. Now, we located that car in Dibble's garage. And we also noted that the front headlamp was broken, as you described, with traces of blood on it. You say you broke that with a karate chop?
Yeah.
That's quite a trick.
Well, I used to do a lot of that before my wife civilized me.
Well, that's really something. That kid's lucky that it was a headlamp and not his head.
I don't want to break anybody's head. On the other hand, I don't want anybody to break my tail either.
Well, as I say, we've got the car in evidence, so it's up to you whether you want to prosecute or not.
Yeah. And do you have the Dibble's telephone number?
Yes, sure. You have a pencil and paper?
Yeah.
I didn't even know who you were. I knew the guys were kind of ticked off about the speed bumps and everything, but I didn't know it was you who did it.
Would it have made any difference?
Yes, sir. No, sir. Please. I promise you it won't ever happen again. Look, I'd really appreciate it if you wouldn't say anything to the police. I know I was wrong. But my dad, he just got another job. And we're just starting to do a little bit better now. It'd really wipe him out if he had to pay for a lawsuit or anything like that.
A lawsuit? Nobody's talking about a lawsuit. This is not a civil offense. It's a criminal offense. They can put you away.
Please, sir. Honest to God, I swear to you, I'm never going to have anything more to do with the guys around here. It's just because we're out cruising and drinking beer, honest to God.
Well, Carl, I don't know. I promise you one thing. If I press charges, you won't go it alone. Your friends will have to shoulder their end of the blame. But I don't know. I'll have to think about it.
I'll show you how.
Thanks. I promise you. It won't ever happen again.
Wow.
really seems to be sorry. Why don't we just wait and see what happens? I mean, now that things have kind of cooled down, maybe there won't be any need to get involved in a court action.
Now, I know I was a little hard on him, but that was the whole point in asking him to come over.
I just want to get on with our lives.
I don't know. But if those boys can get away with running a man down in his own driveway, what's next? I don't want to go to court. We've got kids of our own to worry about. Next time it could be one of them.
All rise. Municipal Court of the State of California, Bogan Judicial District, is now in session. The Honorable William Vernon, Judge, presiding. Please be seated.
Is Dr. Kyler here?
Yes, sir.
And Vance Chandler?
Present, Your Honor.
Ronald Werner?
Mr. Werner is present, Your Honor.
Thank you. Hello, Mr. Faraday. Carl B. Dibble, is he here?
Yes, Your Honor, here.
And the parents of these boys, will they please stand? And you are, madam?
Eleanor Dibble, sir.
I'm sorry, madam, you'll have to speak up.
Eleanor Dibble, sir.
You're Carl Dibble's mother.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, madam. You may sit down. Are Ronald Werner's people here? It was specifically urged that the parents of these boys be present for this hearing. Did you gentlemen make that quite clear to the parents concerned, Miss Faraday?
Mr. and Mrs. Werner are presently vacationing in the Caribbean, Your Honor. However, I was able to contact them by telephone, and they both expressed their faith in their son's innocence and their confidence in my ability to convey that innocence to the court.
I see. And why are neither of the Chandler boys' parents here?
Your Honor, Vance's father is a builder. He was compelled to be present at a construction site in the Palm Desert area today.
What about the mother?
Mrs. Chandler wasn't feeling well, and it was my judgment, Your Honor, that her presence here today could serve no useful purpose.
She must have been feeling very poorly indeed to have wished herself absent from a hearing so vitally important for her son.
Yes, sir.
You begin to see, I think, gentlemen, the root of the problem that we're dealing with here. Parents who absolve themselves from all responsibility for their sons by giving them material things instead of guidance. Now, I am going to postpone this hearing until September the 15th at 8:30 a.m. in this department, and I want one parent for each of these boys present. Now, is that understood? And if they don't come here voluntarily, by heaven, I'll subpoena them.
Why can't we get the trial date moved up? That's almost 3 months away.
Actually, I was surprised we got it as soon as we did. What with the court calendars as crowded as they are.
I have to live with these people. The Chandler house is right across the street.
Well, you could drop the case against the Chandler boy, Al. Just go after the boy who actually did the driving in the car.
I don't want to drop the case against the Chandler boy. He was the instigator behind the whole thing.
What can I say to you? You can't have your cake and eat it too.
My parents almost didn't let me come out tonight.
Yeah, I'm supposed to be home babysitting my little brother.
Poor, he's 8.
He plays with Matt.
Maybe he'll set fire himself.
Well, maybe we should cool it, you know? I mean, maybe I'll spend some time with the horses.
You get off it.
Look, Tyler can't do nothing to us. What can he do? We can only do stuff to him.
Well, I hate him.
Yeah, but he can't do anything because we're only 17, right?
Look, man, it's like a big guy playing the Little League, right? I mean, the rules are all ours. Right, it's no sweat. We'll get rid of him, that's all. I mean, we've done this 20 times already. He can't touch us. By September, he'll be gone.
Well, I hope so. Because my parents are cool, you know? I mean, they don't care what we do. Just so long as nobody complains, you know?
You can't go
come to court in pajamas, you know.
Mommy, tomorrow night's the Hardy Boys, okay?
Okay, if you get to bed on time.
Good night, Tiger.
Night,
yeah. Well,
give me a kiss. Dad, you meant kiss.
Well, not so much in this country, but there are lots of countries in the world where men kiss, sure.
Roger Glick says that his dad stopped kissing when he was 3 years old. And if you keep on doing it after that, it makes you a sissy.
Roger's wrong about that. And I'm going to miss it a lot, but would you rather that we didn't kiss anymore?
When guys get big, they shake hands.
They do, huh? Okay, we'll shake hands then. I will shake hands with you. Good night.
Can I still get a kiss once in a while?
Yeah, that's okay.
Oh, thank you.
No fair. Yes, sir. Thank you, Sergeant. Thank you very much. Not till 8 o'clock tomorrow morning.
Well, how come not till 8 o'clock tomorrow morning?
Honey, the problem is Oak Meadows will only spend enough money for 30 minutes of protection a day from the sheriff's department. They come through here 3-4 times, and when they're gone, that's it.
Well, why did we move into a place with a crazy setup like that?
Because we wanted to. Is that a good enough reason for you? It is for me.
Well, you might have found out about that before we bought the house.
You mean I should have asked the real estate lady, do you think we're liable to get terrorized and murdered by a bunch of kids? I don't know. Somehow I didn't think about it.
Well, maybe you should have.
Well, there's one way to solve it. I can go across the street, knock on a door, and drag the kid out in the driveway and beat him up.
Yeah, that would solve everything.
Well, then we'll wait till 8 o'clock in the morning.
If you have any more trouble, ma'am, you let us know.
There's nothing more you can do about this?
Well, like I say, ma'am, unless you can catch these kids in the act and make a positive identification, there's not much we can do. But I know we're on a job now, so you shouldn't have any more trouble.
Well, what does that mean, you're on a job now? What will happen?
Well, I file my report. I talk to the sergeant.
In other words, nothing.
Well, ma'am, like I say, unless you...
Excuse me, but for instance, why can't you just go across the street to the Chandlers and warn them that if their son...
Ma'am, I can't go harassing people like that without some proof.
Proof? What more proof do you need?
Well, if you can make a positive identification.
This is incredible. We pay you people to protect us, and this is what we get. First you say you'll be here at 8, you don't get here till 11.
Ma'am, I already explained that. The deputy came out here this morning and he went to 9 Wild Stallion instead of 9 Shetland.
Wonderful. Very impressive.
Yes, ma'am. Look, we're only human too, you know? If I were you, I wouldn't upset myself too much about it. Okay?
Don't get myself too upset.
Mommy, should I water the plants now?
Oh, I'll get it for you later. Oh, Bethy, you look like you live in the seed dump. You stay with Bethy, Oliver. Stay.
Oh, God.
When will they call? Oh, never mind. Oh, am I glad to see you.
Daddy?
I saw rockets. They made a fire in the backyard.
Okay. If I followed it, I would have beat those guys up.
Yes, you would. All right, give me the damage.
Here's one. And there's another one.
Lucky you were here. The whole place could have burned to the ground.
I'll tell you one thing. I was really scared.
Did you call the sheriff?
Yes, I called the sheriff, and they said it was a case for the arson squad, and they'd have the arson squad people call me.
Did they?
No, they did not, and I've tried them four times since then, and each time I call, they just say they're out on a case, and they'll call me back.
It's par for the course. I don't know, Muriel. I've been thinking the way things are going.
Jimmy, can we move?
What?
I know we've only been here 4.5 months, but can we move?
I won't be intimidated by a handful of destructive, spoiled brats.
Oh, there are plenty of nice communities where we'd have normal police protection and...
You any idea what those kids will do if we cave in now?
Well, will it be as bad, do you think, as what they'll do if we just stay here?
I won't be run off. Like a bunch of punks. This is our home. It's ours! I'm sorry, honey. What I was going to say was I'd feel a whole lot easier if you weren't here alone by yourself. Every day. And until the trial's over and done with, I think it'd be okay if we gave Thelma a call and ask her if she could stay with it.
Well, that's a lot to ask. She's not a young woman. And...
Well, it's just a phone call. Worst she can do is say no.
Those boys just went by again.
Yeah, well, you just let them start something funny.
God bless you, Thelma.
Broken glass.
Who was it?
cherry bomb. An overload.
You know, you're lucky that this thing didn't go through your window.
Well, Deputy, my final question to you this morning is, what do we do about it? What can we do? It just seems to go on and on, and nobody can stop them, not the sheriff's department, not the highway patrol, not the arson squad.
Did you see the boys?
Nope. They were in the car.
Did you get a good look at the car?
It was dark.
I'll tell you what I'll do. There's not much that I can do officially, but I'm alone now. My two sons are grown and off on their own, and my wife's been dead for a year or so, and I'll be very glad to put in some off-duty time to try to help you to nab these punks.
Well, Sheriff Deputy Tardif, you are a scholar and a gentleman.
There's only one thing I ask which will help me. That is that there be somebody in the house at all times, either yourself, your wife, or your housekeeper. Just so there's a grown adult in there that can make a positive identification if these kids come back.
Yes, sir. You got a deal. Thank you.
The real irony of the situation is that the only meaningful help we're getting is totally unofficial. Would you get that, honey?
Hello? What? Jimmy? Can you pick up the phone?
Who is this?
Dog doctor.
Matt?
Next time we'll blow up your whole house.
My God, what are they made of, those kids?
What did he say to you?
Well, you heard them.
What did that boy say to you, Muriel?
Oh, Jimmy, it doesn't matter.
It was an obscene phone call, wasn't it? It was. Okay, that's it.
Where are you going?
I'm going to go see Vance Chandler's father. What are you doing?
Well, I'll talk to him, Jimmy. I'll go talk to him, Jimmy.
Muriel, you're too damn soft! Muriel!
Jimmy, please, please let me talk to him. You're half crazy. You're running around here like a runaway freight train. You're crazy.
What do you expect me to do? Call the FBI? Let them make a report? I'm sick of it. I've had enough.
Jimmy, please, I'll talk to him.
Oh!
Yes. Mr. Chandler? Mr. Chandler, I need to talk to you. Mr. Chandler, could you turn that off for a minute? Mr. Chandler, if you won't deal with me, you'll have to deal with my husband, and I promise you, you won't like it.
I'll like it fine. Ask him to come on over.
Mr. Chandler, I'm just trying to keep somebody from getting hurt.
Yeah, I know who it is, too.
Well, it will most likely be your son, because I just got an obscene phone call from him.
Now, how do you know it was Vance?
Because I recognize his style by now.
I'll have a talk with him when he comes home.
Well, I think you better do more than just talk to him. I think you better put a stop to the things he's been doing before somebody gets badly hurt. Did you know that those boys put a bomb in our mailbox last night?
Well, what do you expect?
Expect?
Now, listen, you. You go back home there and you talk to that husband of yours. You tell that self-righteous phony baloney that if he doesn't get off my son's back and stop bothering my family, he'll get just what's coming to him.
Why don't you tell me yourself, Chandler?
Ah! To you being violent. Are you all right?
Except for being dumb. It doesn't solve anything. Muriel, what are these? Tranquilizers?
Yes. Oh, Jimmy, it's all right. I just take one a day. Helps me.
Honey, I want you to take the kids and go down to Chula Vista for a while. Stay with your mom. Selma and I will hold down the fort here.
Jimmy, I don't want to do that.
I think it's going to get a little rougher around here before the trial date. You know, as we get closer to it. And there's no reason for you to have to put up with all that.
I don't want to go down to my mom's. I just want to move out of here.
No.
went through all that.
All right. Then will you drop the charges? I mean, just against Vance Chandler and the Warner boy. If that's what they want, why not give it to them? Oh, Jimmy, what difference does it make? My God, maybe we could lead a halfway normal life around here.
Muriel, we started into this thing together.
And we're losing, Jimmy. We're losing. You just don't see it.
No, we're not losing.
Honey, I can't live like this anymore.
It's 2 weeks until the trial. 2 weeks, that's all I'm talking about.
What do you think is going to make it stop after that?
Because I believe that these kids have to find out there's somebody in the neighborhood that they can't buffalo. And when they get that, then they'll back off.
All right. I'll take the kids to Mom's and then I'll come back.
No, I don't want you to do that.
Why, am I going to be in your way?
No, I just don't want to take a chance that you might get hurt.
Well, I don't want you to get hurt.
Muriel, this is me. I can take care of myself. Hold on. Just stay here.
Jimmy, be careful.
We talk every day on the phone.
Okay. Jimmy, promise me one thing, please.
What?
No violence. Me.
I'll do my best.
No, please, I'm not gonna go if you don't promise.
Okay. I promise. So long, Tiger. Now listen, you behave yourself for Mommy and for Grandma, okay?
Okay.
Okay, kiss. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Come here, beautiful. Thank you.
Okay.
You too, you behave.
I will.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. What do you think they wanted?
Just to show us strength. They see you going, I think they got me on the run.
Oh. All right. Remember now, you promised me no rough stuff.
All right. No rough stuff.
Love you.
Have a good trip. Okay. See who did it?
I know who did it. Ron Werner, Vance Chandler, and a couple of their friends.
But you didn't see them do it?
No, they pulled me away from the property and then doubled back.
A couple of minutes earlier and I could have caught them. That's too bad. Produce truck jackknifed on the freeway. Oranges all over the place. Maybe your wife saw something.
Muriel's not here.
When do you expect her back?
I sent her away to her mother's till after the trial.
You sent her away.
Well, I couldn't see any reason to put her through any more of this madness.
Well, I can understand how you feel, Doctor, but I just don't know what you expect me to do unless I have some cooperation. All I asked was that someone stay in the house.
And I do appreciate it, sir. It's just that we'll have to operate without the services of my wife for a while.
All right. Whatever you say. I don't know what good I'm doing around here anyway. All the boys know me now. They're on their good behavior every time I show up.
Well, whatever. You know best.
Oh, my son and daughter-in-law up in Oregon bought a new house, and they invited me to come up for a visit, so if you don't see me for a while, you know why.
Right. Well, thanks for your help, anyway.
I hope everything works out all right for you.
Please be seated and come to order.
Will the defendant, Carl Dibble, please rise? And Mrs. Dibble, two of you, please.
Carl Dibble, as a result of your change of plea to nolo contendere or no contest, to the lesser charge of hit-and-run driving, it is the recommendation of Dr. Jim Kyler, the victim, to whom this court applied for such recommendation, that you hereby be declared the ward of this court, that your care, custody, and control be placed under the supervision of a county probation officer for a period of 1 year. In addition, you will pay $250 immediately, and your driver's license is hereby suspended for 6 months. I need hardly remind you what a very lucky young man you are, and what a great debt of gratitude you owe to the compassion of Dr. Kyler. You may be seated. For the defendant, Ronald Werner, please rise. Also his parents. And Vance Chandler and his parents, will they rise? Ronald Werner and Vance Chandler, in the light of Carl Dibble's change of plea, this court has no choice but to dismiss the charges against you. In other words, by shouldering the responsibility for the act himself, your friend has just taken you two off the hook. To me, that is not a fortunate circumstance. Mr. and Mrs. Chandler and Mr. and Mrs. Werner, your sons, though they have escaped retribution for the time being, are in deep, deep trouble. You know it, and I know it. And if you don't take hold and do something about it soon, these boys are going to wind up in prison someday. However, the law has given both parents and children a second chance. And I sincerely trust that you will make the most of it. Court is adjourned until 8:30 tomorrow morning.
Honey, but I think we ought to give it a few more days. Maybe the judge sobered the boys up, maybe got through to the parents. On the other hand, maybe they were encouraged by getting off so easy. I'll just have to let you know. Well, give the kids my love and say hi to your mom. I love you too. Okay. Bye-bye.
She wants to come home, huh?
I can't let her do it, Selma. I just can't. Things are no different than the way they were before the trial, if you think about it. These kids win every round. Every round. I can't lay a glove on them.
You know what I would do if I was you? I'd buy a gun. That's what I would do.
I thought about it. I really did. But...
Give it to him.
Yeah, come on.
Oh, good boy.
Here, come at the... Come on, boy.
Come on, you don't see this every day.
Come on.
Oh, look at this.
It's free, Oliver. Come on, yeah.
Oh, good boy. Hey, come on, don't be afraid.
We're all your friends. Come on, that's it.
All right, do it! Oliver? Oliver!
attention, please. This town meeting will come to order. Please, we'd like to get started. Are you people standing up in the back? There are still a couple of seats down here in front. Now, we have a number of items on the agenda, so we'd like to dispense with the reading of the minutes, so we can get right into today's business. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
No.
Motion is carried. Now, the first item of paramount importance to all of us is this issue of teenage vandalism. The first speaker will be Dr. Jim Kyler. Doctor, you have the floor. Ladies and gentlemen, please.
All of you should have received a mimeographed copy of a letter, this letter that I wrote the night that my dog was run over and killed by a group of boys from this community. I hope most of you read it. I know some of you have because I've received some answers already, mostly from teenagers, peers of the troublemakers, who, unlike their parents, are not afraid to step forward and name names. Each teenager who responded to the letter named the same six families. And they are the Marty Chandlers, the Hal Werners, the Thomas Brights.
Mr. Mayor, point of personal privilege.
I have the floor, Mr. Mayor.
Point of personal privilege, Mr. Werner.
Mr. Mayor, this man has no right to name names in public without proof. And if you allow it to continue, I'm going to sue for slander. And not just Dr. Kyler, but you, Mr. Mayor, and the entire town council.
Mr. Mayor, may I respond to that, Mr. Mayor?
John, the doctor, has the floor. Doctor, would you care to yield?
Yes, I certainly would. I need all the help I can get.
I'm sure that if proof is what is wanted here, we can supply that to Mr. Werner. Everyone in this room knows what's been going on in Oak Meadows for the last 3 years. They know who those kids are, and they know who the families are.
Mr. Werner, I invite you to sue me. I have witnesses who will testify that what I am saying is true. And I will advertise for more, and I will get them. So, I welcome any legal action you wish to make. It'll spare me the trouble. I will say this to you, Mr. Werner. If you people don't make an effort to control your children, a tragedy is inevitable. And if the lives of your boys aren't worth the effort to discipline them, I suggest you move out of Oak Meadows. You don't belong here. You aren't wanted here. Get out before somebody is killed. Maybe your own son.
Objection, Mr. Mayor! Overruled, Mr. Werner. After, you may proceed to read the names.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Okay, once again, they are the Marty Chandlers, the Hal Werners, the Thomas A. Brights, the Theodore Pridemans, the Howard Riddells, and the Wallace Hullies. I love animals. I always have. Since I was a kid, I've always taken care of them. It's what I do for a living. It's my job. I once had a dog who was a big, lovable clown and never hurt anybody in his life, and now he's dead. His death was the direct result of a total lack of respect for life. And we have had quite enough of that in this community. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Kyler. The council will take the recommendation of censure under advisement. Now, the next item on the agenda is, well, it's one that I'm afraid we're all too familiar with by now. Namely, the raising of taxes for the purpose of purchasing more protection time from the Sheriff's Department. Though it seems to me that Dr. Kyler and John have, well, they've just presented a most eloquent argument in defense of the protection that we so desperately need. Well, the floor is open for discussion. Roger Bunce.
Once again, I rise
to raise what I hope is the voice of moderation. Once again, I must warn against acting out of panic and adopting in haste what we may later regret in tranquility. The plain fact of the matter is that we are talking about undertaking a substantial tax burden because of six teenage boys.
Bye-bye. Hey, Scotty, how's the back, huh? Good night, thanks for coming.
Good night, Joe.
We'll see you tomorrow.
I don't believe it. How could they applaud us and then turn around and vote against more police time? We're right back where we started.
Now, maybe not quite. At least those families know how people feel.
You think that makes any difference to those kids? It's just more talk to them. They've heard it all before.
I'm sorry. I wish I...
No, no. You did all you could. Next time, I'll take care of it myself.
Well, well, look who's here. I do believe you both done some
noise. My darling.
Oh, I love you, and I'm so proud of you.
Well, there's been no trouble for 3 weeks. I think the kids' parents finally got the message they got trouble right here in River City.
I'm sorry I seem to have so little faith in you. I was just scared.
So was I. But it was a good promise, and I'm glad I kept it.
Good, me too.
Hey, champ. Give me a squeeze. Big one.
Hi, Dad.
Come here, honey.
How are you, love?
Hi.
We got a surprise for you. I bet you don't know what it is.
What is it? A birthday party with cake, ice cream, everything.
Oh, Stella, but her birthday isn't until next week.
I know, but it's on Tuesday, and I won't be here. So I thought we'd have a little do-up today before I go home.
Oh, Mommy, ice cream and cake. What kind of ice cream is it?
Hey, Dad, we're over.
Here, champ, you take this one. Take that one in.
Bam! Ain't no fair. You're not supposed to do that.
You're gonna discover what's inside. That's no fair. I wonder what says it. What do you think it is? What do you think it is?
A doll.
A doll? That's the flattest doll I've ever seen. What do you think it is?
Don't shake it so hard. You want a break?
Thelma, it feels so good to be in our home as a home and not as an armed camp.
I know what you mean.
Did you shake this one? That's because you can't even pick it up. What's that? Yeah, try to pick it up. Bloop.
Look, look. His wife's back.
The maid's still there, too.
Come on.
What for?
Let's go and see.
Because what's in there is the biggest surprise of all.
Here.
What's this for?
It's a present. It's from me to you.
Ah. I ain't throwing no brick. Bug off, then.
Are you crazy? For crying out loud, you're gonna get your head kicked in.
Come on, let's put some icing on that cake.
I'm going home.
Go on, then. Who the hell cares?
Happy birthday! Go to your room.
Sarah, get out of here. Go to your room.
My God, Thelma. I don't know what to do.
Get an ambulance.
I thought you said it was over.
She's hurt. Get an ambulance. Going.
I think I should be with her.
Her husband is going to meet her at the hospital.
I know, honey, but I still think...
Muriel, I want you to stay here. With the children.
Why? Where are you going? Where are you going?
Out.
Jim, you promised. No violence.
Muriel, we tried it your way. And it didn't work. Now we do it my way. I'll be back after a little while.
Come on out!